Hey, fellow photographer, how's it going? I'm Michael Zelbel. Today, I would like to look into one option that we photographers might have in our box of tricks, and that is digital makeup. Makeup that is applied digitally after the fact, once we have shot a portrait and the makeup wasn't good or wasn't even there. How can we fix it? And I don't mean it, long hours in front of Photoshop. I mean easy software which just does a trick in 2 minutes or something. So let's assume we have our friend at home and she just came from gym and she doesn't have makeup, and then she comes like, I really need a portrait for my Facebook profile, whatever. Can you do one? You are really good at that. We all have that friend, right? Of course. Now, we photographers, we could explain to her, hey, for a photo, you need a ton of makeup and it should be specific to that photo, and it takes time and so on. And we have to do it another day and yada, yada, yada. Or we say, sure, let's do this. Why not? So today we will pretend that, because I have got Alex over here. And Alex is not that friend. Yeah, she's different. She knows how to model. She is professional in front of the camera. She's a photographer. She knows you need makeup. Yeah, but let's pretend she's that friend and comes without makeup, because thankfully she did that for us today. So Alex, can you come over and help us a bit in this scene? So let me explain. We've got a table in front of a dark background, and Alex is sitting somehow at the edge of the table, and we will take a photo of Alex now. For that, we do a clamshell lighting, classic clamshell lighting, because let's say our friend says, it should look like magazine style, and magazines, they love clamshell lighting. So let's put an LED panel right above Alex, somehow in the middle, and we set that panel to maximum power because we want to have light, right? Let me make sure it's set to 100% power, and it's set to 5600 Kelvin. So that's daylight, because we've got a lot of daylight coming through our windows over there. So I don't want to mix colors all that much. In fact, I'm currently mixing tungsten light from the lamps above myself, but I will switch them off. Not that they would really disturb the photo, but just in case. And because I know you online, you will say, hey, that is stupid. You're mixing in tungsten light from your overhead lamps. But anyway, okay, so we've got the light on Alex, which is wonderful. Now, for the clamshell lighting, we need a fill from underneath. Otherwise, she has got strong shin shadow, which I kind of like, but it's not magazine-y, right? So let's bring in a little reflector underneath the LED panel. So there we go. I will turn that towards Alex until I see. Yes, there's light coming, but I will move that even closer. How about that? Here I go in front of Alex, and there I move it out a tiny bit. Not too much, otherwise it's getting too heavy. Yeah, this is basically where I want to end up. Then let's bring in a camera with our light ready. We've got the camera, which you can see it's currently on f8, which is, well, for me not usual. I usually shoot on f11. So let's bring that up to f11. Fine. With spot metering on her forehead, I see I'm on +1, so there's a highlight. On her chin, I'm on +/-0, so that's perfect exposure. On ISO 1250, fantastic. So we are good to go. We can make our photo. Alex, are you ready? Cool. Then look straight into my camera, like the friend who really wants a portrait for Facebook. Fantastic. And then I count to 1, 2, 3. Cool. Now, let's make it more like LinkedIn. So you have to bring the shoulder forward, like, I want to sell you something. Okay, this is fantastic. 1, 2, 3. Okay, now head straight. Perfect. And now I also do one thing while we are at it. I zoom out and photograph Alex really sitting on the table, because you never know. Probably we need that photo as well. Fantastic. And then while we are at it, I will also do one photo where I'm shooting from some angle of light. Yeah, why not? I mean, let's do that. So I go around with the camera. And Alex, can you follow me with your shoulder a little bit? So you turn that towards the camera and the nose again towards me, towards the lens. And I will zoom in so I don't have so much background in there. Fantastic. Zoom in a bit more. Yeah, there we go. Head straight. This is good. Some arm. 1, 2, 3. Perfect. Thank you so much. You are released from playing our friend who wants to have a portrait. And I will go over to my laptop. So, beautiful portrait on a really dark background. She's really coming out. What I would usually do now is I would open that up in Photoshop. And I probably duplicate the layer. And then I go to filter and select Anthropics Portrait Pro, which is a digital makeup filter. And that might need some time on my super old tiny MacBook, but it does a pretty good job of finding the face in this image and then working on her face. Let's see how that works. Okay, it asked me, is she female? Yes, it got the eyebrows, the shape, and it's not perfectly selected. I could improve that, but let's say I need it in 5 minutes, so this is all I can do. Then it does a bunch of corrections over here, which I may or may not like. For example, do I really need lighting? No, maybe yes. Let's have it on. Does her face need sculpting? It doesn't. It's beautiful. It's beautiful without makeup. It's beautiful without sculpting. But just to show you, I leave it on. Hair, yeah, doesn't play a role in this image. The software already disabled that. And yeah, layers are switched off. That doesn't matter. So I go to next, return, and then it gives me the result in Photoshop. Okay, for a quick 5-minute portrait, I would be already very happy. I'm sure that my wife Emily, who's also here, wouldn't be all that happy. Emily, can you come? Because she is a makeup artist. And if you see digital makeup applied over here, it's not all that much, right?
No.
Yeah, you could do that better with the software. Okay, probably we show that as well. But for me, it would be done over here. I would save it and use the default settings from that software. So for me, the result is already usable for most situations. If it also looks good to you, and if you take digital makeup into your box of tricks, then I wish you a ton of fun with that, and like always, good life.